Hey guys, so last year I made a video on which was the best video editing software for Linux, and I talked about a couple of video editors which were capable enough when compared to their Windows counterparts. And I have been editing videos on Linux for quite a while now, and I'm quite sad to say that Windows is winning, bro. I've always had a love and hate relationship with Linux. Some things would just run amazingly, while some things would just fail repeatedly. And the video editing experience hasn't been any different. So let's talk about why I went back to editing in Windows after trying to edit videos on Linux for the past 3 years. When people usually talk about Windows versus Linux in terms of video editing performance, it's usually a pretty hot topic. Everybody just assumes that switching to Linux will help them render videos faster and increase the overall productivity. Well, to some extent that is true if you have, say, an old machine which doesn't really run Windows very well. Otherwise, with a budget or a decent enough setup, as far as I have seen, the performance is pretty much the same, or maybe a tiny bit better on Linux. Of course, Linux as an operating system is much faster and more efficient than Windows, and that was the main reason why I initially switched to Linux. Because Windows optimization is as good as the postal delivery system here. It's pretty shit. But again, in terms of video editing, both have given me decent enough and similar performance. Honestly, the ease of use depends entirely on the type of user you are. Generally, if you're just starting out on Windows, you just download the software, you install it, and you just use it. Sometimes if you're really unlucky, then you might run into some driver issues or missing DLL files, but most of these issues can be easily resolved by the non-tech savvy people. And even for Linux, it has become pretty easy to install most softwares, especially video editing softwares. But running into issues in Linux is much more common than Windows. I've seen plenty of people complaining about not being able to import videos on their video editors, not being able to install the video editors, and getting endless driver errors and video editors not detecting GPU. And the list goes on and on. And the most annoying part is that the Linux community isn't really very friendly to newbies. If you ask anything remotely dumb about something not working out, and if you're not being able to follow through the instructions because you lack experience with using commands in the terminal, then instead of getting further solutions, you would simply be roasted as if everyone is supposed to be an expert with the terminal. You see, being a firm maker, we don't have all day to run around and dig around websites to find solutions to a problem which shouldn't really have existed in the first place. I know a lot of Linux lovers are going to get angry with what I'm saying, but that doesn't really change the truth, does it? Now, this is where Windows really punches Linux in the gut. When it comes to video editing softwares, Windows has tons of options to pick from. You have Premiere, you have HitFilm, DaVinci Resolve, which actually works by the way, and a lot more. But with Linux, you're quite limited. Like, the closest thing that you can get to Premiere is Kdenlive or maybe Shortcut. Now, you can also use Blender as a full-fledged video editor, and it is one of the best 3D softwares out there. But I can't really imagine making an entire film or even a complex YouTube video with that without spending huge amounts of time. And not to mention that most of the Linux-centric and FOSS video editing softwares are also available for Windows, which work equally as great as they do in Linux, if not better. If you ever have used DaVinci Resolve or After Effects, you might have used a really neat plugin at some point. And plugins these days are really cool and make your editing really fast and effortless. But unfortunately, most of these plugins, even the ones for DaVinci Resolve, simply don't work on Linux. So if you ever thought that you'll save some time by editing on Linux or maybe becoming more efficient, then chances are it's the opposite. While people out there are using plugins on their Windows machine and saving hours of manual work. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not like all the plugins don't work. Only the ones which have to be installed using an installer package don't work, simply because the people who make these plugins won't really bother making a Linux version of them. after all of this, I just couldn't continue editing on Linux. I had to switch to Windows. Now obviously I'm not going to stop using Linux because I love it for what it is, and if you notice, most of these, except for the Linux community, isn't really Linux's fault. The ones who are to be blamed are the video editing companies who simply never really bothered to make a Linux version. If you look at Resolve, they do state that their software works on Linux, but then that's far from the truth. It's not as reliable as the Windows version. It doesn't support H.264 files, which quite honestly baffles me, and in most cases just outright refuses to start on many Linux distros. Linux in itself is an extremely good platform and definitely has a lot of potential. It's just that I really wish that developers had put more focus into Linux, but then again I understand why they don't, as Linux's user base for video editors is quite small. It's actually quite saddening to not be able to do what I love the most in the platform I favor the most. It's like these two are made for each other, yet the whole world wants them separate. And with the Linux community growing every single year and the hardware compatibility getting better than ever before, the future for video editing on Linux looks hopeful and bleak at the same time.